Hi everyone and welcome to our video today. So before we get started, just a couple of things to check. Please do have a little look around your dance space today and just make sure that you've got a clear and safe space to be dancing in. Make sure there's nothing that you're going to knock over, anything you're going to slip or trip on. Also, we're going to be using the bar a lot today. So if you have a portable bar, great. If you don't, it's not a problem. There's still lots of things you can use in your house, but just make sure whatever it is that you use is nice and stable. It's not going to knock over really easily, okay? Also, please do have a drink with you. And obviously at any point during this video, pop it on pause, take a drink when you need. So it's very important that we keep hydrated. And lastly, please make sure that you are warm before starting this video. We have a warm-up video on our YouTube channel, on Facebook, which you're very welcome to use, or to do your own warm-up. Now, we're going to get going. We're going to be doing a pointe class today. This class, though, is still great if you're working on demi-pointe because it's going to strengthen you in your demi-pointe. Think about your placing, really work on that leg and foot strength. Obviously, as well, for the pointe work, we're going to spend the majority of the time at the bar because I just want to make sure that you guys are safe when we're doing home dancing. It's not exactly ideal for doing pointe work. So when we do our bar exercises, make sure we've got that stable thing to hold on to. And then if we do anything in the center, please just make sure that you are safe. Not a slippy floor. If in any doubt at all, don't take the risk. It's not worth taking a risk. It's better to do something on demi points and to do it safely than to have your pointe shoes on and slip and injure yourself. So please, please have a little think about that and make sure that you choose what's best for you. Okay, so we're going to get going with a warm-up exercise for our feet. So just feet in parallel to start with, and we're just going to take four prances to start. So we're going to press over one and two and three and four. Now when you do those prances, really work the three-quarter point. So just from the side, as you're up here, when we make the transfer, we want to see those feet really working through the demi point, the three-quarter point, so that we're not just doing that and that. Okay, so four of those, then we take a demi plie in parallel still, pushing over, stretching up. Now keep the insteps nice and high as we lower down to the ground. We'll reverse that, so we go up, push over, heels down, and stretch. Now let's just take a soft demi plie here in the parallel. One and two and three to find our turnout in first position. Then from there, we're going to take plie releve. So plie releve, plie releve. Four times through, and plie releve. Then we're pushing over, nice deep plie. Now from here, we're going to try and stretch the legs, leave the insteps where they are, as much as you can. Stretch, 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 stretch. Take a little balance, heels down, and then we'll do the same thing in the second. Plie, releve, plie, releve, plie, releve. Four times, plie, push over on the feet. So we're coming into here, pushing over. Make sure you're not too wide in that second. Stretching up, push your heels against the ribbons, really bring them forwards. We'll take a little balance, heels down, and then back into the first position. So remember, if you're working this on demi point, the same thing applies though. When you're up on your highest demi point, try and leave the insteps there whenever you stretch the legs in the plie so that you're really working those feet. Okay, let's have a go at this with the music. Here we go. Prances to start with. And pushing over. Two. Three. Four. Now plie. Press over. Stretching up. Lower the heels, keep a high demi point. Reverse. Push over. Roll down. Now soft demi plie. Demi plie, find your turnout. First position. Plie releve. Plie. Up. Heels forward. Plie. Up. Make sure you're using your glutes. One more. Plie. Up. Now push over. Find the depth of that plie now. Really challenge yourself. Leave the heels forward. Lower down, under control, into the second, and plie, releve, plie, releve, plie, heels forward. One more. Push over. And stretch. Here's our balance. We've got to do that in first, sorry. And tendu, back to the first. Okay, good. Let's pause there. Okay, so let's do one more facing the bar. So we're going to start now in our fifth position. And we're going to take tendu devant. One. Close on two. Then we've got three. Now you're just going to go to the demi point and a four. One more plane, five. This time to the plie, six. And we're going to come to susu, seven and eight. Same thing to second. One and two, three and four, five. Close on the plie, susu, seven and eight. So you'll be changing every time on those ones. So we go to the side, close behind, with the demi point, close front, close behind, susu. So now we can go derrière, we're going en croix. One and two, three, demi point and four. One more, five, demi plie, susu, and down. We'll take one more in the susu, up we come. Let's take our balance. Balance, 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 balance. And then lower softly down, under control. When you're lowering down, really try and use the feet so that you're making that lowering moment very, very controlled. We don't just want to drop out of our point shoes. Okay? So same thing if you're on demi point. I like to describe it like as if you have an orange underneath your heels and you're just trying to squeeze the orange. Make a little bit of orange juice, okay? So you're squeezing down rather than dropping down. So then same thing on the other side. Tendu and close, quick version. Tendu, demi point and close. One more tendu to the plie, susu and down. Tendu, close behind. Tendu, demi. Tendu, plie, susu and down. Tendu and close. Tendu, demi point. Tendu, plie, up and down. One more, up. Then our balance, we won't forget to do that this time. Okay, and then lowering down. So really focus on shaping the foot in our tendus. Even though we have point shoes on, we still need to use the feet, really brush the floor, use that demi point as you're doing the demi point section of that second tendu. Okay, and remember, keep lifted up. So keep long in the sides of the body, use your abdominal support. Okay, let's have a go at that with the music. So, feet in the fifth. Here we go. Tendu devant. And heel up and close. Tendu demi and close. One more. Tendu to the plie and up. Cross it over. Lower. Tendu and close. Tendu demi and close. Tendu out, plie. Use the feet and down. Control, tendu and close. Tendu demi, close. Well done. Tendu, plie and up. Squeeze down. One more going up, up. Let's find our balance. Lower down, stretch the knees, second side, here we go, heel up, and one, and two, and demi, and close, toes back, plie, susu, and squeeze, and out to the side, sorry, demi, what am I talking about, tendu, demi, and in, tendu, plie and up, squeeze down, Come on, you derriere, make sure it's crossed behind you. And one more. Plie. Up. And squeeze. One more, up. Let's find our balance. And lower down. Okay, well done everybody, great job. Okay, so we're coming to now be on the side of the bar. Do remember, if you don't feel confident enough in your point work to just have one hand on the bar, it's okay to do all of these exercises facing the bar with two hands. If you're on deadly point though, definitely sideways onto the bar, please. Okay, so we're going from the fifth position. We're just going to work on the shaping of the foot in this exercise. So we'll prepare the arm. We're going to wrap the foot, one. So this is already encouraging our foot to be in the correct position so that we don't have the sickle foot, okay? Nobody loves a sickle foot. When we're making our foot shape to the in front, we want to make sure that we have a beautifully shaped foot, not dropping down. Same thing derriere. We want to have a shaped foot behind in a fished position rather than the other way round. So we're just going to work on getting into that shape. So we wrap the foot, which means the toes are going behind your leg and the heel is staying in front. So we wrap one to the tendu, two, and you try to maintain that position. Close three and four, then a quicker one and five. We're going to come up to the susu from here. So pushing through that standing leg strongly. Six, lower down, seven and eight. Same thing to second, wrap, two, closing front, three, four and five. That's on the plie. This time we're going to change over the legs. Six, seven, and eight. To the back. Now this time, okay, so we don't wrap the foot round this time. What we want to see instead is the little toe is leading. Okay, so we're along this way around, little toe leading. So we've got one, two, really push that heel down, three, and four, and five. Up, seven, and eight. Then we're wrapping again. Wrap, two, three, four, wrap, five, pushing up. Let's lower down at the end. Then we'll go on to the second side. So wrap to the tendu, close three, four, quick one, and five. Pull up susu, six, seven, eight, all around the clock, encore, and then we finish. Okay, let's have a go with the music. Prepare. Wrap, two, three, four, and plie. Susu, crossover, lower down. Wrap, close in front, wrap out, up, and down. Little toe, and plie, up. Last one, wrap, two, three, close behind. Wrap out, plie up, and lower down. Good, well done everybody. It's not the easiest of exercises, and it's not supposed to look particularly stunning choreographically, but it's a very good exercise for us to do. Make sure as well, when we're doing the susu, it's not something where we're making a big deal of releveing onto that leg. We're working through that foot to pull up and to get into that nice crossed position. Okay, let's have a go on the second side. Here we go. And wrap, tendu, close. Wrap, plie, up, lower down. And wrap, out. Closing in front, use the foot, plie. Now cross behind, that's it. Little toes, close it in, and plie. Lower down, wrap, and out, up, well done, and down we come. Good, good work everyone. Okay, so some more tendus. Just remember, just because you have pointe shoes on, tendus are still just as important because we don't want to feel like our shoe is something different that we just put on every so often and then we're kind of like, oh, it all feels strange. We want every single move that we do in dance to feel just as natural as if we only had our flat shoes on. So, more tendus, working those feet. Let's take, arms for the second, one and two, three and four, five, through the foot to the plie, turning out, six, seven and eight, two to the side, three, four, through the plie, seven and eight, derriere, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now we're going to take little coup de pied, releve, so we've got one, two, three, four, then up into our fifth, five, six, seven, eight. If you're not confident enough to releve on one foot, just do three releves in fifth position. So from here, you'll just do one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Or we have the little passe, up to you, okay? When you're doing those little passes, it's just coup de pied, just neck of the foot. Really make sure that you try to cross the foot each time, so it's not doing a little bit around the houses to get to that position. So you should feel your toe, well, yes, your toe on your leg when we do this one, not your heel though, of course, because if we look from the side, we want the heel to be away from the leg, not laying against the leg, otherwise we're back in the sickle foot territory, which we definitely want to avoid. So from the back, we've got one, two, three, four, five, transfer through the foot, and second, two, three, four, through the foot, and front, two, three, four, through the foot, and coup de pied, coup de pied, fifth. We'll stay here and we'll take, whoop, we'll try to take a balance. That wasn't much of a balance on my part, that's dreadful. Never mind, we'll try to take a balance, okay, at the end of that exercise before we go on to the second side. All right, let's have a go with the music. Nice and bright, here we go. Heel up, through the foot. Derriere. Now, lift, fifth, cross it over, and derriere. Nearly there. Ready for this one? Lift, lift, fifth. Let's take a balance. And lowering down through the feet. Good, well done everybody. Okay, let's have a go at that one on the second side. So we're going to do my favourite and also not favourite exercise now. It's one of my favourite exercises because it's so good for us, but it's one of my not so favourite exercises because it is quite a difficult one and quite a tiring one. But this is such a great strengthening exercise, so we're going to have a go. Now, very good as well on demi-point for this one. We're going to take plié, releve, four times, then on straight legs, four times, five, six, seven, eight. Then we're just going to go to the three quarter points and pop back up, and one, and two, and three, and four. we take a balance, which is quite hard after all that, plie, and then into second. So you guessed it, same thing in second, plie, releve, plie, releve, plie, releve, plie, releve, four times. Then straight legs, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, three quarters, three quarters, three quarters, three quarters, take our balance. Then you have a choice. You can either go back to doing it again in first and again in second, if you are more confident to do this with 2 feet on the floor, or if you're more advanced, we then come to the 1 foot with the foot in coup de pied behind. So obviously, this one is a little bit more challenging. Plie, releve, plie, releve. Four times with those. Down, up, just working the leg. 5, 6, 7, 8, three quarters. Very difficult. Four times through on that one. Take a little balance, swap over sides. Now then, what can I tell you guys to help you with this one? So think about your ribs. When you releve, if you're on demi-point, you still need to know that when you releve, this part of your body is going to be higher than it is when you're stood down here. So I'm here right now. As I go up onto demi-point, obviously, I'm lifted up. Now it helps to think of lifting up from here. So you're moving your rib cage up in space. Even more so on point. When we go up, we really want to go up, not with our shoulders, obviously, but we want to feel so lifted here. Plie, lift. So we're creating all of that space underneath for us to use our legs and our feet. Okay, so think about the rib cage to help you. Also, try not to lean on the bar like it's saving you from something. You are gonna get tired in this exercise. I get tired in this exercise, and we do put some pressure on the bar, but you don't wanna feel so much so that you're, you know, basically leaning on the bar for dear life. Okay, so try to keep it nice and light if you can. We don't want to be leaning forwards because obviously that's going to take us out of alignment. So make sure you start close enough to the bar that you don't feel like you're miles away. Okay, so first position, plie, releve, four times. Straight legs, four times. Three quarter point, if you're on demi point, that means you just drop down a little bit and then come back up again. Four times, balance. First, second, then you can either repeat that or we go right foot and left foot, okay? Let's do it. And plie, releve. Straight legs. Three quarters. Heels forwards. Let's balance. Down we come. Second. And. Straight legs. Now keep lifting in that rib cage. Three quarters. Oh, it's getting harder, isn't it? Balance. Okay, one leg and plie, releve. Straight legs. Good, keep going. Three quarters. It's hard. Balance. And change. Plie, releve. Last one, come on, you can do it. Down up, straight legs. Three quarters. Woo! And balance. Okay, well done everyone, that's a monster exercise. Good job. Okay then dancers, so let's do a rond de jambe now. We're going to start off with quite a tricksy move. So really be careful with this one. If you feel like this one is beyond you, I can give you a different move to do, a different step. But we're just going to start with the preparation, come up to fifth position, and then from here, we're going to take little développé. Now, we're going to releve from here, lift the leg, pass through, and then out to the back. So we're taking that on a releve. If you don't feel confident to do that one-legged releve, just keep it on the flat, okay? But if we're on the point, what we need to think about doing is getting that leg going just a little bit before we releve. If you try and releve from here and then move the leg, it's really, really hard. Also, if you sit into this hip, oh, you're never gonna make it. So we need to be on that standing leg. So we've done preparation and then down one, releve up and open, releve up and open, rond. We take four and three and two and one. Two on fondue, using the feet, shake those feet, and two and three and four. Now we take a susu move. So we move all the way from here. When we get to the back, susu, tourne, tourne, and you see we're back in our fifth, ready to come down to do one. Okay, so we've got one and two. So those were the wrong arms. We were in the fifth position to start with. So we've got one, fifth down, rond de jambe. Four plain rond, one, two, three, four. On the plie, really get that heel up there. Plie, one more to go into our susu, to susunu, back we come, and lower. One, then we start again from the back, and two, and three, rond de jambe. Four rond de jambe, this time we are on de don. Plie, round. Plie and round. One more, plie, up into the susu to turn and lower down. Let's take a forwards port de bras. We'll keep this one short. We'll take a combre all the way back. And then from here, let's try our balance. So we'll either balance in fifth position. So from here, you can take your balance, or we will try a balance in our retire as you wish, whichever one you prefer. Okay, so releve fifth on eight, just to get us going, coming down and tendu one, releve two and three, rond de jambe four rond de jambe five, six, seven, eight, two on fondue. Continue that last one into your soutenu and turn back and then repeat. Then port de bras forwards, come right backwards and our balances. Okay, let's have a go with the music. Prepare. Let's find our releve. And lower down, one. Lift and two. Keep the turn out, knee back and rond. Four plane. Use the floor just because you have pointe shoes on. Don't forget you're still using the floor. On fondue. Keep all that turn out. Now we've got one more. Take it nice and calmly. And lower. And one. Up, down. Show me all those positions. Soften down. And. Now reach long in the back. Now lift up through the back, separate your ribs from your hips. Face into the bar. That wasn't a great one for me, to be fair. Okay, let's move on to the second side. Release the releve, releve. And squeeze down. And heel up. Now really use the floor again. Remember, we want to make sure that we're still using our demi point, even in our pointe shoes. Long backs now, lengthen. Keep the turnout all the way round. Heel up, heel to the front. One more. down we come. And one, get that leg going, leg goes. Well done, it's not easy that, I know. Front. Lift up. And again. One more. Show me that susu, sutanu. And lower down. Hold a bra. Breathe. Lift up. Face it into the bar. Take your balance, fifth position, or the retire. Okay, well done everyone. So those balances are something that I'm still working on. They're not easy, trying to get your weight in exactly the right place. More often than not, you saw me probably then fall backwards a little bit. That's really common. Whenever we're balancing on one leg, on point, it tends to exaggerate if we're naturally backwards. I tend to naturally stand backwards, it's not great. So, I'm correcting myself here, but if this applies to you, when we're in this position, really try and feel the shoulders over your hips so that that position can be a little bit more stable. There you go, so I managed to correct that. I wish I'd have done that in the exercise, but really think about that. It's very, very helpful to think shoulders over hips, not going backwards. I know we're told to lift up in ballet, but actually if you lift up like this, it makes you go back. So maybe think instead about the chest area here going on a diagonal forwards. So when I lift up, I'm thinking more of my chest coming in this direction rather than like that, which is basically a high release. Okay, so forwards, diagonal. Good, well done everybody. Right, let's do some releves facing the bar now. So again, nice and simple so we can focus on our technique. Let's have our feet in fifth position. We're going to take two échappé releves to the side. So we go one, two, three, four. Now we're going to have two releve passe, one going derrière, one coming devant. Five, six, seven, eight. Now when you do that one, really make sure that you are pulling your foot up and down your leg so that we keep it crossed over, keep it crossed over, keep it crossed over, not this one. Yeah, that's kind of ugly. Okay, so crossing over, crossing over. Then we have two more to second. One, two, three, four, one passe, five, six, one susu, and down. That's all. So second, second, this is the second side. Passe, passe, second, second, passe, fifth. Just that, really focusing on getting our legs strong, heels forward, strong through the legs, strong through the body. Okay, very simple, but very worthwhile, all our releves. Let's have a go. Ready? And échappé. Feel the foot on the leg. Single one, susu. Keep it tight. We're going to do this one again. Here we go. Last time, releve. Good, everybody. Well done. Okay, dancers, let's take an adage at the bar now. So we're going to be on flat to start with. Imagine this is, again, like a piece of choreography. We don't always do every single thing on point when we're dancing on point. So take care over your first développé, which is with that wrapped foot, one and two and three, then we are going to come up to susu on four. We're going to repeat the développé now, on point if you can. If you prefer not, just do the same thing again on flat. So then we've got five, six, seven, lower down on eight. Same thing second, wrap the foot, two, three, and up. Sorry, my bad, from here, up to your susu and hit the ivy. Let's go back a little bit there. And then same thing on point, five, six, seven, lower down, eight. Now I'm gonna have to move forward again because otherwise I'm gonna hit the wall at the back. Don't you just love dancing at home? Moving forward, same thing behind, little toe. So remember, I wanna see that little toe moving first before we come into this position. One, two, three, up to the susu, five, six, seven, and lower down. From here, we're going to take tendu en fendu derrière and a pas de bourrée. So it's a pas de bourrée under, which is behind side front. We already know that one. On point, we go behind side front. So it's nice and sharp, nice and neat. Bom, bom, bom. Okay, if you're on demi point, it's the same thing, but just on demi point. I don't know what else to say about that, really. Okay, so just watch that one again. Tendu fondu, and then we go pas de bourrée, and then we finish. You can take a balance at the end if you want, because we have got a lot of music actually there. Okay, so développé devant, four counts. You come down to the tendu to come up to the susu, and then the same développé, but on point or demi point. So if you're on demi point, you should still be doing the first one on flat, then come up to the demi point and repeat your développé on demi point. So one to the front, up on point or demi point, second one to the front, come down to the side, close front, susu, to the side. Derrière on flat, up, arabesque. Then we take our time, nice and slowly, just to make sure we can get this all sorted out, take a little balance, and then we'll go on to the second side afterwards. Okay, so keep lifted up, really think about all of those things that we've spoken about, lifting up in the ribcage, not doing my fault, which is chucking your shoulders backwards, so we want to keep our shoulders over our hips. Okay, let's have a go. It's nice and slow. Let's prepare. Wrapping the foot, and one, two, three, up to your susu, four, and lower down under control, and again, wrap, up to susu, and lower down, straight legs if you can, little toe. Second side, here we go. And wrapping the foot, peel the foot, wrap. One, two, three, susu, and lower down on straight legs, focus on control, wrap. Good, well done everybody. Right, let's have a look at temps lié. So again, a very important step on point and on demi-point, but particularly on point because we have to think about how we're getting there. So we're going to take temps lié en avant. Really think now of pushing off of this back foot and joining those feet nice and strongly together. So we've got one coming forward to bring the arm to fourth. Then we've got en arrière. Now, have a little moment here. So we've just been practicing in our développé, that little toe moving first. You've got the same thing here. So imagine I've stepped forward into my temps lié. As we prepare to go backwards, you still need to have that shaping of the foot. Otherwise, we're going to step backwards. Sorry, I don't know if you can see that. Oh, don't do that. Okay, it's really dangerous and very ugly, so we don't want to do that. So from here, little toe, push backwards, and we're making a strong movement. Temps lié needs to be strong. Don't be scared of it. If you're very scared of it, and you just kind of pull your leg back under yourself, it's really hard, actually. If you pull your leg under yourself, you don't have the space to get up onto point very easily. Okay, same thing even on demi-point. If you step it out and push with that front foot, you'll be able to create more space for you to get up onto your points. Then to second, so we're going to cross the leg nearest bar. It's going to come into the front, cross in front, and again, cross in front, and down. So we've got en avant and two, en arrière and four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. Saving my point shoes here because they're getting a little bit dead. And then we take one more en avant and two, release the back foot, little toe up, three and four. You can take a little balance there if you want. And then turn, six, seven, eight. En avant. Here it comes. Hopefully you can see my little toe coming towards you now. En arrière. Second. Second. En avant. Release. And then that little balance, if we can, before we turn around. Okay, dancers, so again, nice simple exercise. We're going to do this more continuously. Forwards. What do you mean forwards? First side. Oh dear. Can you tell it's been a long week already? So first side and then second side. So you will end up with my back to you. I've tried to make this video so that I put my front to you for most of the exercises, but this one is continuous. So sorry, you'll get to see my back for a little bit. Okay, right, let's have a go. Ready? And take your weight with you. Little toe. Cross it over. Cross it over. Temps lié. Release. And little toe. One more. And down we come. Well done, everybody. Okay then, dancers. Now, this is an exercise you could do in the center, but like I said at the start of this video, I want to make sure you guys are safe, so please don't do anything in the center unless you are absolutely 100% convinced that you're not going to slip or trip or anything like that. Okay, so if you want to have a go at the bar, great. If you want to try it in the center, also great, but just be safe. So we're going to start off with a bourré. Now, if I've got any gents doing this class, you don't want to do this bourré to start with, okay? You instead are going to take for me from here, just walking, using the feet. Walk and walk, plié. That's what my gents are going to do. And I really want to see you, gentlemen, as you do this one, show the foot, plié, and then change. Show the foot, plié, and then change. One more time on that one, because it's a little bit switching back and forth with the feet. So we start with the coupé. Coupé, show the foot, plié. Now that front foot swaps behind. Coupé, show the foot, plié, swap it behind. Okay, ladies, we're going to bourré. So like, let's go. No, let's just think a moment. When we beret, let's think about the back leg really crossing over, which is what's going to push us along, not doing this version. Oh, okay, that's not a beret, that's just horrible and odd. Okay, so it's almost like your thighs are trying to stay together. As we make this beret, you're crossing over, use the feet and the ankles. We do a little pick up and down, then back the other way. Beret, cross the legs over, up and down. Now, everyone together takes ton lié now. Ton lié, show the foot. Ton lié, show the foot. Now, you have a choice now. You can either do another ton lié and then be ready to start on the second side, or you can take a pique into your arabesque. So from here, using the bar, pique into your arabesque, and then from here, we can do pas de bourrée, and then down. So you've got bourrée, or walk, and change. That's that little pick up, keep that foot connected there. So from a bourrée, foot connected, and down. Bourrée back, or walk, foot connected, and down. So we should all end up in this position. Coupé, ton lié, ton lié. Show the foot, arabesque, pas de bourrée, and down. Okay, so we'll have a go with the bar. Like I said, if you want to have a go in the centre, that's great, but we'll stick with the bar for the moment, okay? Here we go. And we're in a walk. Up and down. And again, we're in. Down. Now show the foot, ton lié. Tight legs. And tight legs. Stepping out onto that foot. Pas de bourrée. And again. Bourrée. Up. And. And ton lié. Cross it over. Bring your weight with you, shoulders over hips. Show the foot, pique. Pas de bourrée, and down. Okay, well done everybody. Okay dancers, so you can see my bar has disappeared. Now, I said we needed to be very careful in the center, but I'm gonna give you an exercise which isn't actually a point exercise as such. We're not really going to be going on point, but it's for the balance in your pointe shoes, so it's perfectly fine to do this because it's all on flat, apart from the last little bit, which you can do on demi-pointe if you wish, so I give you an option there. So this is just to practice standing in our pointe shoes because, as we all know, when we put pointe shoes on, they feel like this, and your feet feel like they wobble, okay? If you're taking this class on flat, this is still gonna be great for you. We're working on our développés and a strong standing leg. So don't think that this is just aimed at the pointe workers. This is one for everybody, okay? So, strong développés. This is a dull exercise. It's really boring. I'm so sorry, but it's very, very good for us. Okay, so I'm not gonna win any choreographic awards with this exercise, that's for sure. We are just going to take développé to the front, tendu and close. It will be a lot higher than this. 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. This is just so you can get the pattern. 1 and 2. Arabesque. Oh, there goes my foot already. Did you see that wobble back? We've got to try and keep on that foot. 3 and 4. Now from here, this is the only bit of pointe work, so you don't have to do this. But if you want to, and if you're safe to, we're just going to take from here our ton lié forwards, 6, 7 and 8. If you don't want to do that, or if you're not safe to do that, you simply take a step forwards and close. Okay, so we have développé. Développé devant. Let's do it properly this time rather than that small mark. So we've got développé devant, 2 and 3 and 4. Développé à la seconde, 5, 6, 7 and 8. To the arabesque without a wobbly foot, hopefully. Oh, no, it's still a bit wobbly. Never mind. We'll work on that one. And then our ton lié, coming forwards, 6, 7 and 8. Same thing on the second side. All the way round, close, into the tonlier or just your step forward. Okay, so this is not easy. It looks like it should be so easy. It's just different pace, but you suddenly get this wobble going on and then it's a little bit hard to correct. So we'll give it a go. What tips can I give you? Try to think of keeping your weight more in your toes. If you put your weight back in your heels, you're going to be back here anyway. Okay, so keep the weight into your toes a little bit. Okay, again, think about the ribs being separated from the hips, so we create a lot of space here. We can utilize all of our support. And what's the golden rule in dance? The golden rule in dance, well, there's many golden rules, but it's always better to fall forwards than backwards. If you fall forwards out of something, you can save it. If you fall backwards out of something, you're just going to look like you fell over. Okay, so with that having been said, if anything, make sure that you're focusing on these shoulders again and we're not doing that. Keep those shoulders over your hips, keep that stomach engaged so that you're on top of your leg. Same thing here. I mean, just imagine if we fell backwards in that position, it's gonna look terrible. Okay, right, are we ready? Let's have a go. Step forwards. And second side. Focusing on your standing leg. Tonlie. Well done, everybody. Okay, dancers, really well done today with all that work. That's a lot that we've tried to work through. Let's come together for a bow or a curtsy. And ladies, let's step to the side. Lift up. Now the gentlemen, stepping to the side. Two arms and bow. Thank you very much, everybody. Keep working on those exercises. Keep working on everything that we've spoken about. Really shaping those feet, making sure that we're not trying to do this. I know it's a big thing. Like, I spent my life trying not to sickle this foot because it's a horrible foot. It's getting there. So we've all got things to work on. But very, very well done. Grab a drink. Make sure you cool down and stretch out. Well done, everyone. Bye for now.